Karnataka. Let's bring you something now closer home. Now, after Rajasthan, the state of Karnataka is facing an outbreak of swine flu. At least 456 people have tested positive for the H1N1, and 5 people have died due to the flu since Jan 2018.
Meanwhile, Deputy Chief Minister G. Parmeshwara held a meeting today with health department officials and civic officials to discuss an action plan to control the spread of the H1N1 virus.
Precautions are generally, since it is an airborne disease, the precautions would be personal protection, and whenever a person has flu-like symptoms like sneezing, cough and running nose, he should isolate himself, or the family should isolate him and get him treated. In the initial phases, the flu-like symptoms subside within 1 week's time. In a severe cases, like in a B group, we have a severity of high fever, high-grade fever, and body ache, vomiting, and diarrhea, which need to again to be isolated with, of course, Tamiflu, which is a drug of choice for managing these H1N1 cases.
Almost about 900 hospitals have been brought into a MIS reporting system, wherein any positive cases will be reported immediately to the municipal corporation with the details of the patients. Once we get this information, immediately our health staff will visit that particular patient's house, give proper treatment with full of, give them the proper awareness to their close relatives and who are with the family.
Yeah, we have got everything. We have got 2 beds, isolated beds for male and female, and we have ventilated facilities of more than 20 beds. And then we have have a stock of oseltamivir, we have stock of PPE kit, we have stock of N94, everything we have got. We have trained our doctors, nurses, and technicians, everybody, and then we have orientation program regularly. So there is no panic for any patients as such.
Shrija MS joining us on this big story. Shrija, we are talking about a figure somewhere around 456, which means close to 500 people tested positive. Now, this is a very big number. Is enough being done to curb the spread of the virus? What are the immediate challenges before the health authorities?
Well, that's what we have to do.
Okay, we are having some difficulty in getting through to Shrija. We'll try and get connected with her in just a bit.
Right, and we're seeing on the government's part these daily meetings being held between chief minister or top state officials and the civic bodies. Now, a number of these cases, of course, come from the city of Bengaluru simply because it's the most crowded area. So the more crowds there are, the quicker the disease actually spreads.
Right.
Efforts being undertaken to try and figure out a way to curb this. These crisis meetings are on a daily basis to see what preparedness the government has for to deal with the disease.
Right. Shrija is back on the line. Yes, Shrija, please continue.
Well, the latest number that we are picking up from the health department stands at 456. Apart from that, we've also been told right now nearly 5 people have lost their lives here in whole of Karnataka. We also see an emergency meeting has also been called by the Deputy CM G Parmeshwara with the Bengaluru Bharat Mahanagarapalika Mayor Gangambike, as well as various other BBMP officials, to discuss an action plan to contain this particular virus. We also see the government have also taken several measures. One particular measure that we are looking at this point in time is the distribution of Tamiflu tablets and also awareness, which is right now being created across the state.